Hello, my name is Nita.
I'm Vijita.
Today we're going to be teaching our second half of the Mukunda Mukunda choreography. What we're going to do now is we're going to show you what we're going to teach, the first half of it, and then we'll go through it like we've been doing before, point some fast feet and then full speed. So we'll go through that bit. So in that bit, we finished last time in this. So when we end here, we're doing this. So this shows it's a normal position of what, like Rama or most of the murtis are in the mandir. And we're talking about Mahima, which is their greatness. So we're depicting that through this gesture. So right hand up, left hand down. And then we're going, whoever doesn't know your greatness, so, and then submerge, so whoever doesn't know it, I'm going to go like that. It's like saying whoever doesn't understand your greatness will be on like a path of destruction, essentially. So this not understanding and the path of destruction, we're going to show like a quick hand falling like that. It just shows that you're destroying everything. It makes like a cross if you do it with both hands. We're going to do one hand at a time. And then, because like they're not destroying, like they're also destroying their brain. So it's like destroying their brain. And then that person, and you're going to show like that Shiva thunder sort of, because he's a god of destruction when he's in that thunder phase. So you're going to have that Trishul, and you're going to hold like left leg up, slightly tilted, and hands up here. Okay? So we're going to start off with Mahima Tumhari Jobi, Sama Jinna Pai, Kaakh Me Mil Jai, Vo Khal Kaami, and then Esa Vigyan. So a learned person who doesn't understand it. So we're going to show a learned person like this. So you're going to have your right hand come up, left hand go down, and you're going to sit with your left knee down, right knee up. Oh, sorry, right knee down, left knee up. Okay? So Esa Vigyan Jobi, Tujhko Na Maane. So again, if a great learned person doesn't understand you and they don't understand your bhakti, so we're going to show the bhakti like this, okay? And he doesn't understand your power, so shakti. So we're going to show that with your right hand coming underneath your left, like that.
In a fist.
In a fist. And we're going to talk about his part in Gita. So when Krishna does the Gita, yeah, so we're going to show that bit. So when he speaks what's written in the Gita, and he tells Arjun, so we're going to show Arjun. So we're going to turn around from our left, we're going to sit down on our right knee, and we're going to go in that famous pose that Arjun is normally at when Krishna gives the Gyan. Okay? So, jo paath padhaya tha tumne Gita ka Arjun ko. And then that is still relevant in my life, is what we're going to show next. So, we're going to show that by lighting. So imagine this is a matchstick in your right hand, and you've got the box that you're going to strike the matchstick against. You're going to light a couple of diyas, so candles, and then that's your path in light, life has been lit up. So you can show a path by putting your hands forward like that.
Stepping with your hands almost.
Okay? So should we do that bit, and then in point of best speed, and then we'll show the rest of it.
Jeevan,
soul is yearning for Krishna. So you're gonna show your soul, like you're gonna take your right hand across and like that, okay? So maybe at the marko, Abhinasata says, please stop like making me yearn for you. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then come quickly and show me your true self. So we're gonna show you that. We're gonna bring arms together, do a quick spin, and it's like the opening of a curtain, you know, when a drama first starts. So it's like that. So that, and then we're gonna go into the Krishna phase, because when the curtains are open, Krishna is right there. Okay, so we're gonna go through that whole bit from 75 feet. Or you can do it as this, whichever one you prefer. So we're gonna do that bit in full speed now. It's the second chorus we learnt in the last session. So we're showing Krishna up and down, and then Mujidhanamete Virinda, Virinda. So showing Vrindavan.
Yeah.
What we're going to do now, I'll show you the next bit, which is what we pass to the holy scene. It's a little bit difficult because there's no words, so it's just a lot of beats. So what we'll do is we'll show it to you with the music, and then we'll count them with you as well,
so that you know when to change which mood you're doing. Jaldi se aake mohe daras dikha re Mukunda Mukunda Krishna Mukunda Mukunda mujhe daan me de Vrinda 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 by showing Radha or any gopi just walking. So we're going to do this with our hands. So our ring finger and our thumb are going to come together like this to show like a veil, a gungat, to show Radha's just walking normally. So we're going to take like two steps sort of. So one, two, but like really slow steps. So one, what I like to do is count the beats with my feet. So just rock backwards and forwards with both feet. So one, two, as Radha's walking, and then we're gonna change to Krishna, and Krishna gets mischievous. He sees some color, some like holy color, yeah. So he picks it up, and he's gonna put some on Radha's face, okay? And then we're gonna show Radha, and she's gonna be like, naughty. And then she gets some, and puts some on Krishna's face. But Radha gets shy, so she's gonna run off, because she's really scared that Krishna's gonna put some more on her. So after putting some on, she's gonna run off, so you're gonna show her with her veil again. And then what's gonna happen is there's gonna be color flying everywhere. So color flying this way with your right hand, color flying this way with your left hand. You want to hide from it, so you hide your face, like stop, okay? And then the music changes a little bit, but we'll do it with the count so that you know. And then Krishna comes and he's gonna pick up a water gun. So you're gonna walk back towards the right back corner slowly, and you're gonna fill up a water gun. Then you're gonna aim it at Radha, and you're gonna squeeze, and you're gonna push all the water on her. And then you have a couple of seconds, so you're gonna show Radha hiding her face. And then the music changes again, and now Radha has gotten all wet, so she's gonna dry her hair on the right-hand side. Oh, it's water falling, sorry, on the right-hand side, water falling on the left-hand side. Then she's gonna wipe her face with her right hand, wipe her face with her left hand, and now she's gonna dry her hair, sorry, on her right-hand side. So it's like she's got a plait in her hair and she's like squeezing all the water out of it. And then with her dupatta, she's got water in that, so she's gonna hit it to get all the water out. So that's gonna be three times, one, two, three, and then you're gonna spin because now we're changing the scene. So we want to make a clear distinction. So it's gonna spin to get ready for the next bit. We'll try that all with the
counts.
Music.
No, we'll counts. Do it with the counts.
Yeah. So, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Okay.
And then the next bit of the music changes is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then the final bit, the music changes again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Once more with the counts, I think.
Yeah, we'll do it once more with the counts. So as you can see, the counts, the beats is very different, so our counting speed changes accordingly. But if you keep it at that speed, then you'll understand the music more, and that's when it changes. One more time.
One, two, three, four, five, six, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay, I hope that was useful. So we're going to do that bit and 0.75 speed.
One, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Before we do it in full speed, I'd just like to say, make sure you're feeling mischievous when all the colors flying in the air, and when you're showing Krishna filling up his water gun. But then when you get really wet, you're going to be really annoyed at Krishna. So make sure you're annoyed that you're really wet, so you're drying yourself, but you look a bit annoyed, but still a little bit happy because you had fun. मुझे दान मिले बिंदा 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 and do the next bit. Show you the next bit and then we'll go through the steps again. Of Vishnu, as well as like bits of Krishna in there as well. So we stopped spinning Radha, and then when she's done this bit, she spins. As soon as she spins, sit down. So again, right knee down, left knee up, and then I'm going to show water, okay? Because we're talking about a ship that's been stranded, and Krishna helped to get to shore. So we're going to go water, and he guided them. So we're going to take our left hand, we're going to spin with it. Okay, so we're going to spin with it like this, and he guided us. Okay, so water guided us. Okay, and then Gita ka gyan deke. So when he gave the Gita gyan, he awoke the world. He kind of like, yeah, salvaged the world. So we're going to show him with his chakra, which is Sudarshan chakra, and he's going to walk forward with it. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to show everyone with the namaste pose. We're going to turn around. And again, we're going to do the curtains opening thing, okay? So, Gita ka gyan deke, jagko jagaya. And music, so it's four counts. What we're going to do is going to do like a flower petal throwing. So, in your left hand, you'll have some flower petals. In your right, you're going to pick them up.
Pick them up with like this sort of hand gesture.
Yeah. So we're gonna pick them up and we're gonna first go to the left corner. We're gonna go one and then we're gonna change hands. So now the right hand has the petals and the left hand is being used to throw them, okay? So first it's the right hand throwing, then it's the left hand throwing, then it's the right hand throwing, and then it's the left hand throwing again. Okay? Happens four times.
In all four corners.
In all four corners. So we start off with the left corner first. So right hand, left hand, that one, and that one. Okay? We're going to do that bit with the music.
Choreography.
So the next bit is it's talking about touching, well, basically making the sky and the earth come together. So we're going to come together down. So we're going to sit down with our hands going to the left corner. We're going to go down like this. Okay, so I'm going to sit down at the same time. So it's going to be sitting down, touch the floor. And now I'm going to show it coming up. So our right hand goes up and it's going to be a star. So the way we're going to show a star is we're going to have our hands like this. And it's going to be like in a little bud shape and it's going to open up. It's like a bright star. Okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we're going to show his nursing group. So that was when he was like
half lion, half human.
Yeah, half lion, half human. And so we're going to show that with our a lot of inner strength. So you have to look really kind of scary as well. So you're going to have your hands as claws. And you're going to bring them back, okay? And then he killed Hiranyakashipu with that. So we're going to bring that, we're going to walk forward, and we're going to take, like again, like a tushul. So it's like a three-forked sort of fork, and we're going to kill Hiranyakashipu with it.
Okay? I tried it.
And so we're going to show nursing, which is his half-man, half-lion avatar. And we're going to kill him. Hiranyakashipu, and then Ravan. So we're going to show Ravan with lots of heads. But what we're going to show with is we're going to have our hands like in a little like C shape. We're going to show like depict heads like that, and it's going to go like that. So imagine like you're trying to have like 10 heads because Ravan had 10 heads. So and he like cut them all off. So Ravan kesar ko kaata, and then we're going to show Ram. So we're going to take a bow, arrow from our quiver, and we're going to have a bow. And we're going to stretch it and let it go. So basically, this is Ravan. His head was cut off by Ram shooting an arrow. Okay? And then Radhe. So we're going to show the Krishna avatar now, which is going to be Radhe ka manchiraya. So we're going to show Radha. So it's going to be a Bhungat again. Bringing in and then up and then Prem. So we're going to show love. So that's going to be like hand coming down onto our heart and we're just going to tap it. Okay? So Radhe ka manchiraya prem ranga leke. Okay, we're going to go up to that pain point and 5 feet. So the way we're going to do it is we're going to show the two things like this across our eyes.
then they open, so it's like inside our eyes. So line your eyes and then open the two fingers. So mirin ne no me, on the me you open it. Pula kilim, flowers bloom. So I can do a little rotating, little bit of rotating our wrists around each other to show a flower blooming. So the way you do that rotating is like this. So mirin ne no me, pula kilim. So and then with the flower, we're going to take it around us. And I'm going to smell it because they smell really really nice, obviously. So mere ne no me pula kilim. So the tere khushbu kim, and then majiban saathi. So we're going to do this. So the two fingers are going to hit together like dandelion sticks almost, and we're going to make a little circle around our head, and then we're going to touch the palm, and then bring it to our heart. Okay. Jivan Sati Juno de Libero go chukim. And then on whose head am I going to place the peacock feather? So giske matesajon. So you're gonna ask the question on whose head. So you're going to like be like who as a question, who? So giske matesajon, and then you're gonna pluck a peacock feather from the air, and you're gonna hold like a mirror in front of your face, so just like this, and then you're gonna like, on whose head am I going to place a peacock feather now? Kiske mate sajong, mora bunkadera, kaisa dio janamose. So you're just going to make a circle with your right hand, make a circle with your left hand, bring them together to the center to point to the camera for me, but to whoever's in front of you, and then bring it to your heart. So kaisa dio janamose, tu hai mera. And then it goes to the chorus. So we do the first chorus. So this one, Mukunda Krishna, four times. Virinda. So because it's the last one, we want to have an ending pose. So after doing Virinda, we're going to bring the hands from the sky, from up here, down. So they look like this. And we're just going to look up at where our hands used to be. So we look at our hands. Bring our hands down, but our face stays up there. So this, de mujhe me de virinda, virinda, virinda. So we'll do 9.75 times with the music. Reach the floor, so you touch the floor and bring it to your heart. So four times.
We'll do it full speed now. We'll do the whole thing 0.75 speed, and then we'll do it full speed afterwards.
Yeah.
We'll just do the whole thing full speed. Thank you. Thank you everyone for joining us. We have the dance choreography of it up as well if you want to see what the whole thing looks like together.
And practice with it if you want to as well.
And please do subscribe to our channel, like the videos. We do put a bit of effort into them, so we really hope you guys enjoyed it. And we hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.
Bye.